third from beyond the arc, perfect from the free throw line.
I'm watching the game this very game right now.
As well.
Yeah. Can I finish this game real quick?
If you're Bill Self right now and there's a missed free throw, you have to be prepared to switch on all dribble handoffs. They have the team to do it. I want you to watch inside. Watch Mika, Luke, and Vic and see if they X inside and screen for each other with the idea of coming up with a long miss. If he makes it, Rich, it's still only a two-point game. I don't take a timeout here. I push it. Both teams have one timeout remaining. Possession arrow is with Baylor.
Just remember, they have one more free throw. Oh, it was a bookie move.
One-point game, last shot time for Baylor. Now, no holding. You get the best first one with a chance to offensive rebound, and he's got to go. Look up.
That's it.
And Graham cradles the ball, and he'll go to the line. Pay heed all who enter, Fran. It's going to be another tight one. Well, this is a great play by LeConte. He gets what he wants. Good hustle on the backside. You see the block out right there by Vic. Devontae comes down with it. And Baylor fouls. And Devontae Graham, I don't know if it's a cramp or he got hit. It looked like he was stretching out his calf before walking across the court to go to the free throw line. Now, Rich, let's assume he makes both, okay? Baylor's got one timeout left. They can inbound this ball to midcourt and call time. If it's two or one, Baylor will still likely take a timeout. If they decide not to take a timeout and they get it in quickly, LeConte will have three dribbles to get the best look. But nothing happens until Devontae shoots the first free throw.
One dribble per second, right?
In this case, it may not apply because I would throw it to midcourt and call a timeout. If this second one goes through with Baylor, I let the ball hit the ground, and I set something up where I can throw the ball at least to midcourt. One timeout remaining for Baylor. No Joe Nwolachul. He has fouled out. The leading scorer for the Baylor Bears this evening. Good play by Lindsey. He's going to wait till his team is set, and then he's going to inbound it. 3.4 to go. And that works out well for Baylor, because now, let's see if Scott Drew uses his timeout, because now the ball is on the sideline. Unless he's got a great three-point play in his pocket, I would call a timeout here. But he doesn't need to, because they need to go to the monitor to make sure the ball is off Kansas.
So now both coaches get to huddle up their respective teams. And this is what the officiating crew is looking at right now, trying to make sure whose possession it is.
That's awfully close. This is a long, high angle for us.
Tristan Clark, the Baylor Bear, 25 in black, trying to catch it. That's LeGerald Vick, number 2 in white.
My first instinct is that this ball is off Clark. They've got to have a definitive look at overturning this.
The initial call was Baylor basketball. That's almost too close to overturning.
Okay.
Will be Baylor basketball.
So now, Rich, if
Baylor
you will
basketball.
Sell, do you take the chance of fouling here? Remember, we've got 0.2 on the clock.
They're going to change the clock and make it 2.9 when that ball went out of bounds.
Now, what I would do here, if I were Baylor,
I would run a play, and we everybody has this play. It's got to be some sort of screen and a catch and shoot play. If you're Kansas, you have to be very careful not to foul here and foul a guy purposely who winds up being in the act of shooting. Kansas can also switch at all five spots because they have five guards on the floor.
Keep an eye on number 20 in black, Manu Lacoste. Instead, they lob it. Loose ball, and Kansas escapes.